There was one thing I missed in Rich Hickey's most recent keynote that I want to talk about today. Hi, my name is Eric Normand, and these are my thoughts on functional programming. So in 2017 at the Clojure Conj, Rich Hickey gave a talk called Effective Programs, and he explained, mostly it was like explaining the design decisions behind Clojure and what kinds of problems he was trying to solve and the kinds of decisions that he didn't even really realize he was making until, you know, 10 years in, just being able to reflect on what he was doing at the time. And it had to do with these programs that have to react to stuff happening in the world and make decisions in the world and also be changing over time as the world changes over time. So there's all this motion, everything's changing. And Clojure was designed to address this. And in the talk, there was something I missed. Because I wrote a response. There was a lot of talk in the presentation. There was a lot of talk about static types and how they weren't helping with that particular problem. They were great if you had a static problem and you wanted to model it in a type safe way. You could do that, but then when you have this idea of the world is changing, and so your program has to adapt, like the code has to change, you have this timeline of your types changing over time, and there just isn't a model of that. Anyway, he brought up types a lot, and so I wrote an article with my interpretations of it, because a lot of it was oblique. It wasn't the topic of the talk, so this was kind of tangential to it. And I felt like the talk needed a little bit of context. Now, I don't know if I did a great job of adding any context to it. I actually felt like people who it only like deepened the divide between static and dynamic types, which was not my intention. My intention was to share my personal experience working in Haskell and comparing it to how I felt working in Clojure and why I thought some of the statements he made a lot of sense to me, on a personal experiential level, not any kind of like objective level or anything. So anyway, the response I got for my article was like people who liked Clojure and dynamic types liked my article, and people who liked static types had a lot of objections. So I don't think it clarified anything. So I haven't found the key yet, because I think that we are too divided and we need to be more unified. But I rewatched the talk recently, and I actually missed a lot of stuff. You know, I think I had seen it live, and then I watched it one time after that before I wrote my article, just as research to make sure I was, you know, remembering stuff correctly. And then I rewatched it recently, and there was something I missed, something very important that I didn't pick up on. And it was that when you're dealing with you're working on a problem, there's often a lot of sub problems where you're working on the partial, like you have a partially solved problem. Right, you're like halfway through the steps that will finally solve the problem, but you're only halfway. So you have a partial solution, or you have, say, partial data because you haven't finished making the data yet. And so what you have is you can't use the type that you will eventually have at the end, which contains the entire solution. What you have is a piece of that. And what piece is it? Well, you want the flexibility to be able to choose the piece that you want. So are you going to make a new type for that sort of half solution? And this is something he brings up where you have, you know, you say, well, a person has a name and it has an address and it has an employee status and, you know, a salary. It has all these things. And as a whole, that makes sense. But very often, all you have is the first name and the employee status. Right? Like, you're in some part of the code that only needs those two things. And so are you going to make a new type just for that piece? And what do you even call that type? Right? And then another part needs the first name and the address because it's going to mail them something. So what they're going to need this other piece, right? And you need to name that type. And this, he was using this as an example of one of the reasons why spec is the way it is, that in spec you define what the keys mean independent of what data structure they are in. So person/first name is always going to be a string with certain characteristics, and, you know, however you define it in spec, regardless of what else is around it. And so that lets you put the pieces together as you need them in a way that, you know, they might not even be part of this bigger entity. They're part of some sub-entity or some other thing. You know, how do you join them, right? Like, you have the whole set library, Clojure.set, that contains all these relational algebra things. And is there a type for each join, for each kind of join to do? So this is, you know, this is what he was talking about, that you need a data model and not just a bunch of concrete types. Because a data model is an abstraction, and concrete types, like a person has a first name that's a string and has a last name that's a string and an address that's an address type that has a street and a number and a zip code, and, you know, those are concretions, not abstractions. And you need a program to abstractions. I mean, that's been clear for a long time. So that's something I missed, that it's true in typed languages, you have this problem where the solution always seems to be more types. You need more types. And when you look at the recommended stuff from, I don't know, maybe it's an extreme faction of Haskellers, but they say, we can't use strings except as, you know, at the bottom, but we always wrap them in a type so that we know what that string represents. You know, that's where you need to go. In the same way that you would say person/first name is a string, it's not empty, and it, you know, maybe has a capital first letter. You know, I don't know what you would say for a first name. Seems like you don't want to restrict that too much. But you would want to define, instead of using strings, you would want to define a first name type and a last name type and an address type. And a zip code type, and everything would be typed in the way that we're now starting to do with spec. We're speccing every key, right? So then you get to put them together in combinations. Anyway, that was something that I had missed the first time, and I just wanted to talk about it. All right, thank you so much. If you want to get in touch with me, I want to hear your thoughts on this, especially on my article, because I feel like this is the kind of thing that I would love to have a very clear treatise on. I don't know if one article could ever do it. it's just a really complex issue, and it's, you know, I don't even want to talk about the issue. It's something for another episode. But if you have complaints about my article, I really want to hear them. I want to know. This article is called Clojure versus the Static Typing World. Okay, I really want to know what could make this article stronger. Like, what are your objections to it? Because this is important to me. I think that we're too divided, and so I'm sitting there on the inside, and I'm like, what's unclear to me? It's clear that we're too divided, and when I make a statement, I'm not meaning to divide us more. But I'm just not able to express it. So I just want some help here. I want to know what's going on. Please, I'm Eric Normand on Twitter, and you can also email me, Eric@lispcast.com. See you later.